I'm Chris Douglas. I'm a business owner, an employer, and a wealth manager, and I'm here to set some facts straight about the tax code that made America great and what it might take to do it again. Let's start here with the American tax code in the year 2021. As you can see, there are seven brackets based on income levels, with each bracket taxed at its own marginal rate. At the bottom, we have married couples filing jointly who make less than $19,900, taxed at 10%. At the top, couples who make about $628,000 or more are taxed at 37%. Some with higher incomes may pay surcharges based on the Affordable Care Act, but those charges only apply to part of their income. This is because our tax code is progressive. You pay the higher rate of each bracket only as your income grows to meet it. So if you and your spouse made $87,050 this year, you'd pay 22%, the next highest rate, only on the last $6,000 you made. That's because the lower bracket's maximum is $81,050. Seems logical, right? But as simple and straightforward as today's tax code is, people have a lot of opinions about it. Some think taxes are too high as they are, and others think taxes aren't high enough for the wealthiest of Americans. Regardless of your perspective, one thing is certain. Today's tax code was not an accident or a work of nature. It was created deliberately. Along the way, it has completely changed the way America's economy has functioned. And it's no accident that you probably don't know anything about its history. Here's a question. What do you think the top federal income tax rate was in the 1950s? For so many who talk about when America was great, this is the period they talk about. It's America becoming our most prosperous. The era of the single income family, a starter home for all, a car in every garage, seemingly endless economic opportunity. But what you don't hear about is that all this was the product of the tax code of the time, which looked like this. Looks pretty different than today, right? 24 brackets, a smooth gradual increase in rates, and a top tax rate of 92% on income over $400,000. With inflation, that amount had a lot more buying power than it does now, making those people the equivalent of today's mega rich. Because of the tax rate, that buying power got shared. Not only did a 92% top tax rate work in America, it worked well, not by giving money to the government, but by causing the wealthy to think about money very differently. I was amazed when I uncovered the truth of the 1950s tax rate. Since then, I've had the pleasure of posing that question to senators and governors and candidates for Congress and fellow business owners, and guess what? They didn't know either. I believe understanding the history and impact of these changes is key to restoring the economic stability we once aspired to share with all Americans. Please follow along with me through the rest of these videos as we explore how the American tax code was manipulated over the decades and what it might take to make American capitalism begin working again, and for everyone.